Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Chicago Cubs franchise mode series here in MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. We're jumping back into July of 2015. Yeah, I know, kind of back in time because this game started a couple of editions ago and has been ported over through MLB 14 and then 15 and now 16 as it continues, because these game saves do indeed import from year to year. Still the only sports game that really does that, and I still don't know why, but it's great, and I wish Madden and all the others would follow suit. Anyway, you got Starlin Castro highlighted there for the Cubs and Chris Sale for the White Sox. It's going to be a battle for Chicago today. One team doing much better than the other at this point. That would be the Chicago Cubs. As you see a backhanded play by Baez, the throw gets him. No, they say safe. The stretch by Rizzo, not enough, but hold up a second. Maybe we're going to challenge this? Let's take a look. Waiting for word from the dugout whether we should challenge or not. Oh, it's close. I'm going to go ahead and challenge that. I think he was out by half a step, so call comes in from the dugout. Yep, thumbs up. Let's go ahead and challenge it. Why not? Give it a shot. So the umpires will get on the headsets, and we take another look at it. I don't know. It's really close. I know tie goes to the runner. Let's see what they come up with. Are they going to overturn it for us? No, they're not. They say safe, and we have squandered our challenge on the first batter of the game. Oh, well. And it's worth a try, I guess. Anyway, that's over and done with. We will have no more challenges for this game. Tanner Roark then follows that up with ball four right there, and all of a sudden two base runners on for the White Sox, who are having issues winning games here. But there is a strikeout of Jose Abreu. That's a big time strikeout right there, and he gets one out. 1-1 count, and oh, that's past Chris Bryant at first. Runner coming around third, he will score. As you see the runner going first to third also. Oh, wow, okay. Tanner Roark a little shaky here in the first inning. Could have used that reversal of the call on the review, but he didn't get it, and well, that is a solid single to right field. You saw he was trying to put that lower in the strike zone, and it got up a little bit, and he pays for it. It's now 2-0 White Sox, and we've got a visit to the mound to try to calm Tanner Roark down. He's won 9 games of the season. Had a nice 9-3 effort so far in the first half, but this one looking like trouble. There's a pop-up in foul territory. Rizzo was under it, and there's a big out number two. Maybe the visit to the mound calmed him down here, got him a new frame of mind, and he can get out of here with nothing else across. Nice curveball right there for strike three swinging. Gordon Beckham goes down, and Tanner Roark gives up 2 runs in the first, and then escapes without anything further happening. So let's see what the Cubs bats have to say about things today against Chris Sale, who is a very disappointing 4-9. I think he embodies the whole Chicago White Sox team right now. ERA not terrible, 3.08, and obviously must not be getting the run support from his lineup. Look at that, Rizzo beating the shift. By the time they get over there and fumble the ball around a little bit, he's easily into second base with a double. Yeah, that's the dangers of putting a shift on. Sometimes hitter will figure that out and go the other way. So Chris Bryant's going to take ball four on a full count. And you've got 2 runners on with 2 outs. First inning, 2-out rally. All this started here with 2 outs. You see Sale missing inside and putting a little pressure on him to throw some more pitches in the inning and try to get out of here with the 2-0 lead. Baez says, nope, that's not going to happen. Base hit to center field. Runner is Rizzo coming around to score. And the Cubs have cut the lead in half for the White Sox. 2-1 now as they answer in the bottom of the first inning. Solid hit right there by Baez, driving in a run. And now you bring Charlie Blackman to the plate. He's worked a 3-2 count. Already 21 pitches for Sale in the first. And that is going to be down for a hit. Of course it is. It's Charlie Blackman. He's like the contact king in this game. And he comes through with an RBI single. We're all tied up. Both teams getting 2 runs in the first inning. Cubs answer right back. Nice little compact swing right there. Always makes great contact. This is Charlie Blackman, one of my favorite players in the show. just because of that. He always seems so clutch. Anyway, Castillo. Wellington Castillo, that's bad luck right there. Did you see that? The ball hit the third base bag. That should have been down the line for an RBI and a Cubs lead, and instead, the White Sox get out of the inning. Let's watch that again. Right down the line. Whoop, yep. Not only did it hit the bag, but it stayed right there for the third baseman to make a barehanded throw. That's quite lucky for the White Sox. This is going to be a ground out and a much more successful top of the second inning for Tanner Roark. Like to see that right there after your team got you your runs back. So let's go to the bottom of the second and the top of the order. Byron Buxton, he's going right center field, and that is going to roll almost to the warning track. He's got wheels, and he is showing it. 99 speed gets him to third base standing up. It's a triple, and he's quite accustomed to doing that as he is tied atop the leaderboard in the National League with Billy Hamilton and Bryce Harper. All right, so with him at third base, Starlin Castro trying to drive him in. Instead, he is going to ground out for out number three of the inning. So the Cubs do not take the lead after the Buxton triple. Sale gets out of the jam. So 3-2 count with two outs for Tanner Roark, and that's hit to third. Chris Bryant's going to throw over. Easy play. And Roark cruises through another one. Shaky first, better second and third inning, and we remain tied at two. Let's go to the bottom of the third, and Javier Baez is a bat with two outs. Cubs seemingly doing a lot of damage with two outs as that is in the gap. He's going to have two. Well, hold on. Is he going to go for three? Yes, he is. Never hesitating, the throw and the head first slide. He's safe. You've got two triples in the game now for Cubs hitters. This one going to Javier Baez, and he has six on the season. He doesn't want to be left out of the party. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Charlie Blackmon, one for one with that single and RBI. He's got a runner at third base, but it is two outs. Let's see what he can do. Hits the right field and a dive, and he doesn't come up with it. It's behind him and slowly rolling to the fence. Oh, man, is he going to try for it? This could be an inside-the-park home run. Rounding third, coming home, the throw. Not in time, Charlie Blackmon, inside-the-park home run. How fun is that? Cubs take a 4-2 lead. Again, the contact king in this game every single time. Perez made a dive for it, and, well, maybe should have just stopped short on it and played it on a hop, because Charlie Blackmon rounds the bases and gets a two-run inside-the-park home run. So Tanner Roark has that 4-2 lead now. See what he does with it. Ground ball to Rizzo. Back to Tanner Roark covering. They get the double play and out of the inning. Let's go to the bottom of the fourth. Cubs got that 4-2 lead now. And Junior Lake getting into the act with a ball to right center field. That's going to be extra bases. Is he thinking three? Nope, he's going to stop right there at second base and get things going for the Cubs. Nice job by him right there. Standing on second with nobody out. Tanner Roark at the plate. He's going to go ahead and bunt him over to third, and that's a beautiful bunt, drawing the third baseman in to make the play. No one at third to even think about covering right there. So the sacrifice moves. Junior Lake over to third, and you've got Byron Buxton, who tripled last time. He sends a roller through the infield. That's going to be an RBI single. I say this time and time again, as I have Buxton in a lot of my franchises because of the potential. But man, I so badly want Buxton to figure it out in real life for the Twins and produce like this. That'd be great. Chris Sale, all of a sudden, another rocky start as he's given up five runs and counting. Jose Abreu is going to send that one to right field. Charlie Blackmon, easy catch to end the inning. And Tanner Roark doing quite nicely with his second chance after that rough first inning. Sixth inning, Byron Buxton's up again. Oh man, he's tripled and he has singled, and now he has homered to dead center field. Solo homer for Byron Buxton. Man, like I said, start playing like this in real life, I'd be very, very happy Twins fan. Anyway, that is crushed to center field. I think he's got like 14 on the season, which is very surprising at the halfway point that he has that home run production. But yeah, that is a very big plus for the Cubs lineup to have Buxton producing like that. So we've got a 6-3 lead now in the seventh inning as we fast forward it a little bit. The White Sox got one back, and they're threatening to hit a home run here deep to left, and it is caught at the ivy. Just enough room for Junior Lake to make the play, and we carry a now 7-3 lead into the eighth when Chris Bryant's going to find the gap. That's going to roll to the fence. It'll score at least one. Another runner. Now he's going to stop at third base on the double by Chris Bryant. Did you see his game the other day? That 5-for-5, 3 homers, 2 doubles. Historic game he had the other day. Pretty awesome. Charlie Blackmon, are you kidding me? He had the inside the park home run. Now he's got one that leaves the park. Either way, it's 2 home run game for Charlie Blackmon as he continues to dominate towards the bottom of the order. I disrespect this guy so badly. I hit him like 7th. And he does this. His 8th home run of the season, 2nd of the game. This one of the more natural variety as it leaves the ballpark opposite field. And the Cubs have put the route on at 11-3. Let's see if they can just finish this off with Pedro Strop in the game. 3-2 count with 2 outs and strike 3 on the splitter. Cubs win. Take the first game of the series against the Southsiders. I'm sure most people in Chicago still hoping this will be this year's World Series matchup. Keep it in the Windy City. Charlie Blackmon, your player of the game with 5 RBI, 2 homers, 1 inside the park, 1 left the park. He completely knocked it out of the park as far as his performance today. The Cubs actually lose 2 out of 3 in this series. That's a little disappointing. So we've reached the halfway mark. And when we come back next time, we'll see which Cubs made the All-Star game. Maybe somebody in the Home Run Derby? I'm not sure. Anyway, the Cubs, a game and a half back of the Reds. We'll see you next time for more Cubs baseball.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.